Suppose a company's revenue function is given by R of Q, and its cost function is given by C of Q, where Q is hundreds of units sold and produced, and R of Q and C of Q are in dollars. Part A, we want to find the marginal profit function, which is the derivative of the profit function, and then part B, how many items need to be sold to maximize profit, and what is the maximum profit. So before we find the marginal profit though, we need to find the profit function, where profit is equal to revenue minus cost. So notice how here we have the revenue function minus the cost function. Let's go ahead and simplify this. P of Q is equal to negative Q to the third plus 360 Q squared, and then we have minus 11Q minus 480. Now that we have the profit function, we can find the marginal profit function, which would be the derivative of the profit function, or P prime of Q. So the derivative with respect to Q would be negative 3Q squared plus 720Q minus 11. And now for B, how many items need to be sold to maximize the profit, and what is the maximum profit? To maximize the profit of this function here, we want to begin by determining the critical numbers, which is where the first derivative, or the marginal profit function, is equal to zero or undefined. So let's begin to find the critical numbers on the next slide. Notice how the derivative function is a quadratic function, which is never undefined. So to find the critical numbers, we'll set this equal to zero and solve. Unfortunately, this is not factorable, so we'll have to use the quadratic formula to solve this, where a equals negative 3, b equals 720, and c equals negative 11. So using the quadratic formula, we would have q equals negative b, or negative 720, plus or minus the square root of b squared, or 720 squared, minus 4 times a, which is negative 3, times c, which is negative 11, divided by 2 times a, or 2 times negative 3. The discriminant, or the number underneath the square root, simplifies to 518,268. So we have two critical numbers. One is q equals negative 720 plus the square root of 518,268 divided by negative 6. And the other is q equals negative 720 minus the square root of 518,268 divided by negative 6. Let's go ahead and get decimal approximations for these. This first value of q is approximately 0.0153, and the second value of q is approximately 239.9847. So again, these are the critical numbers which should maximize or minimize the profit function. And of course, we're trying to maximize the profit function. So to determine whether we have max or min function values at these values of q, we need to use either the first or second derivative test. Let's use the second derivative test to determine the concavity at these values of q. And let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So the second derivative, or p double prime of q, would be equal to negative 6q plus 720. And now we'll determine the sine of the second derivative at our critical numbers to determine if the function is concave up or down, which will tell us whether we have a maximum or minimum function value. So we'll find the sine of p double prime of 0.0153 and the sine of p double prime of 239.9847. With this small value of q here, we should be able to recognize that this function value is going to be positive or greater than zero, which means that this critical number, the function is concave up, which means we have a low point, or a minimum function value. So this is not the value we're looking for, because we're trying to maximize the profit, not minimize the profit. And now we'll find the sine of the second derivative at the second critical number. So we'd have negative 6 times 239.9847 plus 720. Notice how the function value is negative, and that's a good sign because that means if the second derivative is negative, the function is concave down, which means at this critical number, we have a high point or a maximum function value. And we are asked to round q to two decimal places, so this means the profit is maximized when q is approximately 239.98. But if we go back to the original problem, remember q is in hundreds of units. If we multiply this by 100, that means when q is approximately this value, 23,998 units are sold. So even though we found the value of q, our answer is going to be the number of units here, which is 23,998. Now they also asked for the maximum profit, so now we need to evaluate the profit function, not at this value here, but when q is approximately 239.98. And remember, our profit function was this cubic function here. And now we'll go back to the calculator one more time. Running to the nearest cent, the maximum profit would be 6,908,880.08. I hope you found this helpful.